Hello everyone, this is third part, cash flow to creditors and stockholders. Cash flow we looked at in part two, which is cash flow from asset, should be distributed to the party that who provides funds. Who are they? They are creditors if they provide debt financing. So they lend money to the company, or stockholders if they provide equity financing, who own stocks. So to get the cash for the creditors first, there are two factors that affect this cash flow. The first factor is interest expense. So interest expense is first factor. Minus, the second factor is the net new borrowings, which is change in net and long-term debt. So if interest is paid to creditors, then cash flow to creditors, this is cash flow to creditors, increases. If company borrow more money from creditors, then cash move from creditors to company, so that's negative factor of cash flow to creditors. What about stockholders? Cash flow to stockholders, again, two factor. One is the dividend factor, the other is the new equity factor. So if dividend is paid to shareholders, stockholders, then cash flow to stockholders increases. The first factor is the dividend payment, and second factor is net new equity raise. So if company sells stock to stockholders, then stockholders' cash come from stockholders to what? To whom? To company. So that's negative factor. That's change in common stock account and also additional paid in surplus account. So when company raise money, so for example, if company sell initial share for $50, okay, it doesn't really mean that the face value of stock is $50. Face value may be determined by company freely. If face value is determined by $5, then this $5 is recorded as common stock accounts, and the other $45 recorded as additional paid in surplus accounts. So these two accounts are related to new equity raised. So let's look at the example. Cash flow to creditors. Webster's has long-term debt of $52,600 as of year-end. The long-term debt was $47,900 at the beginning of the year. During the year, the company paid a total of $4,800 in interest. What is the amount of cash flow to creditors? So cash flow to creditors, usually we use CFB, B is bondholders, equals to interest paid, 4,800, minus, now long-term debt changes, so 52,600 and long-term debt, and the beginning is 47,900, leading to $100 cash flow to creditors. Cash flow to creditors is $100 here. What about cash flow to stockholder? Again, example, Mansfield and Company has a net income of $136,800 for the year end and paid $84,000 in dividends. The balance sheet shows an ending common stock balance of $220,000 and an ending paid in surplus balance of $330,000. The beginning common stock balance is $180,000, and the beginning paid-in surplus balance is $250,000. What is the amount of cash flow to stockholders? From the formula, cash flow to stockholders equals to first dividend paid. So dividend is, here's dividend, $84,000. Minus net new equity raise, that is common stock plus additional paid in surplus account changes, right? Ending common stock account is $220,000. And the ending paid in surplus account is $303,000. Minus beginning common stock account is $180,000. Beginning paid in surplus account is $250,000. Cash flow to stockholders is $36,000. With this simple balance sheet and income statement accounts, we can easily get cash flow to creditors and cash flow to stockholders. Next slide is pop quiz using the same financial statements in part two. Let's calculate cash flow to creditors and cash flow to stockholders and compare to cash flow from assets. Using these same financial statements, cash flow to bondholders start with interest paid $70. Minus long-term debt changes, long-term debt is here. 454 minus 408. How much? $24. Cash flow to stockholders start with dividends, 165 minus, now here they have one account, common stock, and paid in surplus account, 640 year end, 600 beginning, $125 cash flow to stockholders. In part two, we already calculated cash flow from asset, which is $149. Just verify this. 24 plus 125 equals to 149. This identity rule should hold. If not, you need to go back to find your mistake. Financial cash flow, free cash flow, this identity rule should hold. Okay, so this is the end of the chapter two. Thank you for watching chapter two video, and let's meet the next chapter. Goodbye.